reasons. Cheeky green parrots. And sneaky green snakes. These snakes don't just slide and slither. They can jump too. Lots of animals are green, so they can't be seen. Remember the green tree frogs? There's one hiding in that plant.
Show me your magic.
Get ready to dance with Boogie Babies on CBeebies next. There's one present you can open early this year.
Ooh. Presents!
Oh. CBeebies Christmas Eve treats.
Yeah. Yeah!
The atmosphere here is fantastic.
Yeah. Oh. Totally radical.
What's this one?
Ooh. Wow.
Come on, team!
That'd be fun!
Well, it is Christmas Eve!
CBeebies, share the magic! CBeebies, share the magic!
Happy Christmas!
Happy Christmas!
Happy Christmas! From all of us to all of you. I like frost on window panes and licking sticking paper chains.
I like tinsel on the tree.
Is there a present under there for me?
I wish that Christmas would never end when we're with our CBeebies friends.
We'll wrap up warm from head to toe and play outside in the winter snow.
Happy Christmas to everyone. Happy Christmas with lots of fun. May your wishes all come true. Happy Christmas from all of us, from all of us. Happy Christmas to everyone. Happy Christmas with lots of fun. May your wishes all come true. Happy Christmas from CBeebies to all of you.
Happy Christmas!
Dance, dance, dance. Come and dance with Boogie Beebies. Dance, dance, dance. Come and dance with Boogie Beebies.
Boogie
Beebies.
Boogie
Beebies.
Boogie Beebies. Boogie Beebies.
Yes! It's Boogie Beebies! Your chance to dance. I'm Boogie Pete and I want you to join in and copy me. But first, let's warm up our bodies. So clear a space. Put a smile on your face because we're going to let the music into our bodies. Oh, I can feel the music and it's in my head. Oh, is yours nodding too? Oh, it's moving now. It's in my shoulders. Ooh, is it in your shoulders too? I can just feel it bouncing around. Oh, I think it's moving. It's in my arms. Ooh, it's making them go forward. Ooh, like this. Hey, it's in my hips. Whoa. And the other way. Whoa. Oh, it's moving again. It's in my legs. Whoa. It's making me pick up my knees. That's it. Yes. Oh, it's moving again. It's in my hips again. Woohoo. Oh, and the other way. Whoa. Oh, it's moving again. It's in my arms. Oh. This music goes everywhere. Whoa! Now it's gone into my shoulders. Oh, is it in your shoulders too? Oh, it's in my head again. Ooh, I just can't get the music out of my head. Oh, I think it's going somewhere else. Oh, it's in my whole body. Yeah, it's making me move all around. Oh, the music's gone.
Boogie Beebies, Boogie Beebies, yeah.
Brilliant, now I feel ready to dance. Do you? Great. Well, you better get your woolies on, because we're heading for some wintry weather. It's cold and crisp, and icy white flakes are falling in flurries, which can only mean one thing. It's snowing!
I wish it would snow, I wish it would snow.
I wanna get wrapped up from head to toe.
I wish it would snow, I wish it would snow.
I'd rush outside to a world that's white if I could make one little wish. I wish it would snow.
Look at me! I'm Boogie Pete, king of the snow slopes, and I'm ready for some more snowy fun. But can you still remember all the moves for the chorus? Let's see if the Boogie Bunch can. Let's do the snowflakes one way, and then the other way. Let's wrap up warm and give a little shake. Let's do the snowflakes again. That's it. And now let's rush outside to play in the snow. Let's wish for some snow. And then, hey presto, there's the snow. That's the main part of the song, and it's called the chorus. And it'll be coming back again and again. So don't worry if you didn't get it right the first time. I'm sure you will once you've heard it a few more times. But now we need to find some moves for the verses in our song. The verses are the bits in between the chorus. Let's see what we can find. How does the snow make you feel? Does it make you feel warm? Or does it make you feel cold? Well, it makes me feel cold. And when I'm cold, I give a shiver. So let's do some shivering moves in our song. We can shiver with our bodies, which then makes our knees knock together. Like this. Come on, try that one with me. Let's shiver our bodies, which makes our knees knock together, like this. And I don't know about you, but I always hope it snows in the holidays. So let's hope it snows in the holidays by moving from side to side like that. And then, hey presto, here comes the snow. Let's get ready for some snowy fun. I love the way the sledge slides across the snow as it curves and speeds down the slope. Let's do some sledging moves of our own. We can pretend that our hands are the sledge, and then we can move them down like this, as if they're shooting down the slope. Whoosh, whoosh. You can move them any way you like. Whoosh, whoosh. Now, I don't know about you, but I love to feel the snowflakes on my arms and face. So let's put out our arms and look up to the sky. Ah, feel those snowflakes. If you want, you can move around in a circle, but make sure that you don't get dizzy. Well, we've got all of the moves there, and all together, they look like this. Let's start with the shivering move. And ooh, that's it. Let's knock our knees together. That's it. Now let's do a hoping move for the holidays. And then let's make some snow. Let's go sledging. Woo! Are you sledging? And now let's feel the snowflakes on our arms and on our face. That's it. Boogie Bunch, are you ready to play?
It's been ever so chilly lately. My knees have been knocking together. I'm hoping for the holidays. There'll be some real snowy weather. Then I can go sledging in the park. And maybe
come too. If only it would snow, then my dreams, they would come true.
Now it's your turn. Try it with me.
It's been ever so chilly lately. My knees have been knocking together. I'm hoping for the holidays. There'll be some real snowy weather. Then I can go sledging in the park, and maybe you could come too. If only it would snow, then my dreams, they would come true.
Great sledging! We'll need those moves for the big video later on. But right now, let's stay cool and check out some of the ways you like to dance. Do you, Boogie?
And this is my friend Alicia. Today we're doing line dancing.
Baby, baby, what you do to me? Got me falling like a leaf from a tree. Wish I knew, do I do it to you too?
In line dancing, we stand in a line.
We touch. Don't believe that I could give you up. Wish I knew. Do I do it to you too?
There are lots of steps to remember.
We put our hands on our belts to make us look like cowboys.
Make you see. Love.
I like pretending to be a cowgirl.
Yeah!
I got you like I've been got. Wish I knew. Do I do it to you too?
My favourite step is a scuff. Let me show you how it's done.
How we like to dance.
Bye!
Boogie Beebies, Boogie Beebies, yeah!
Well, now's your last chance to practice the chorus moves before the big video.
I wish it would snow, I wish it would snow. I wanna get wrapped up from head to toe. I wish it would snow, I wish it would snow. I'd rush outside to a world that's white. If I could make one little wish, I wish it would snow.
Ah, you're looking really cool! Well, there's snow going back now, so it must be time for the big video. Look out for all the moves we found today, and remember to join in with the chorus when it comes along. Are you ready to boogie?
Yeah!
It's been ever so chilly lately. My knees have been knocking together. I'm hoping for the holidays. There'll be some real snowy weather. Then I can go sledging in the park, and maybe you could come too. If only it would snow, then my dream they would come true.
I wish it would snow, I wish it would snow.
I wanna get wrapped up from head to toe.
I wish it would snow, I wish it would snow.
I'd rush outside to a world that's white. If I could make one little wish, I wish it would snow. Every everyone loves some snowball fun. When the snowflakes are fluffy as feathers, we could roll a huge snowball and make a snowman together. We dress him up smart in a fancy hat and a walking stick made from bamboo. If only it would snow, then my dreams, they would come true.
I wish it would snow, I wish it would snow.
I wanna get wrapped up from head to toe.
I wish it would snow, I wish it would snow.
I'd rush outside to a world that's white. The world would still look bright after dark, and we'd make footprints up the path, and every child would shout hooray, jump up and run outside to play.
I wish it would snow, I wish it would snow.
I wanna get wrapped up from head to toe.
I wish it would snow, I wish it would snow.
I'd rush outside to a world that's white. If I could make one little wish, I wish it would snow. I wish it would snow. I wish it would snow.
Yes, you really made it snow. Just listen to that applause. You'd better take a bow. Well, it's time to go now, so you better come inside, take a deep breath in, and blow up a big...
Bobby Nogs next, here on CBeebies.
We're live from the Bobblesburg Winter Games. And they're off.
Come on, team, chop chop!
Bob and the gang are off to Bobblesburg. But the Winter Games are in trouble.
The machines that build the courses can't come.
The race is on to save the games.
We've only got 2 days.
Zoom, zoom, zoom!
Can Bob's dream team finish in time?
Yes, we can!
Bob the Builder snowed under at 11:05 on Christmas Eve.
See, baby, share the magic.
It's a big day today, Owen. Going to say goodbye to those armbands. You'll be great.
Hello, Bob and Oggs. I'm not looking forward to this. I'm feeling nervous.
Oh, dear.
Eat up, Owen. We've got to go to the swimming pool soon.
Oh, I'm feeling really nervous now. I've got so many butterflies inside my belly.
I'll just go and pack your swimming bag.
Oh, you do look worried.
Hi, Oggy. I'm sure you never feel nervous about anything, do you?
Well...
Oh well, Bobby Noggs. Time for you to go back to the bubble hat.
Good luck, Owen.
We can all feel nervous when we do something for the very first time.
Try that again, but a lot quicker.
We're the Bob Bob Bobby Nogs.
Yes!
The Bob Bob Bobby Nogs.
Oh. Whatever is that?
It's coming from outside. The dragons are flying past. Look! There they go!
Loads of them! Look at them all!
They're heading for Dragon Mountain.
They're flying in from all over the world. It's the Dragon Festival. You don't often see many dragons at once. Now, where were we? Let's start after two. One, two.
morning. Cedric Scales at your service. I'm so sorry for dropping in like this.
Are these things yours?
Ah, yes. I was flying past on my way to the Dragon Festival when I dropped my suitcase.
And do you play the banjo?
Of course. Most kind. Thank goodness it's not broken. I'm playing in the Dragon concert tonight. Well, must be going. Sorry about the ceiling. Cheerio, then.
Oh, thank goodness he's gone. Dragons make me nervous.
I say, I've had a thought. I see you play instruments. Are you a group?
Yes, we're the Bobby Nogs.
Wonderful. You can play at the Dragon concert.
But...
play in front of dragons?
We've never played in front of...
We'd love to.
Wonderful. Dragon Mountain, 7:30 tonight.
Huffity puff, let's keep it gruff. Welcome, guys and gals, to the Dragoragon Show. Well, folks, have we got a good show for you tonight. We've got Fingal Fang, our favorite joke teller, Cedric Scales on his banjo, but top of the bill tonight, a brand new act, the Bobby Nogs.
Oh, no. I feel so nervous. I'm not sure I can... Are you all right, Oggy?
I can't do it. I'm scared.
We're on in 30 minutes. Oh, I feel really nervous too. We're all feeling nervous.
We'll be fine once we get on the stage. We're the Bobby Nogs.
Oggy, where is he? He was here just now. Oggy!
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 Oi!
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 Now what comes after all that laughter? Yes, folks, it's the Lady of Illusion, Madame Cascara.
No sign of him. He's gone.
I think he was scared. He tried not to show it. But where is he gone?
I think I know.
Hello there.
Cedric, we need your help. We've only got a few minutes. There's our house.
Get ready to land.
Whoa!
I just felt so scared. I couldn't play in front of all those dragons. They were all strangers. Does everyone feel like this when they do something new?
There are things you need to see, so you should take a look through me.
See, Oggy, everyone can feel nervous when they're doing something for the first time. Like the first day in nursery school, when we don't want to say goodbye to our mums and dads.
She looks nervous, just like I feel.
Don't worry, Oggy. The butterflies soon disappear, and she doesn't look nervous anymore because she's used to the place. These things just take time. For example, learning to ride a bike with stabilizers. One day, we'll learn to ride without them. Just as Owen is about to swim without armbands for the very first time.
Oh, he's looking a bit nervous if you ask me. Go on, Owen! There he goes! And look, these children don't look nervous now either.
That's right. They're beginning to enjoy their first day in nursery school.
She's really settled down. Oh, look! Oh, they've all made new friends too.
So it's fine to feel nervous sometimes, but the more we get used to things, the more we learn to enjoy ourselves. Oh, wow! They look like they're having great fun! All their butterflies have gone!
You see? Very soon, you forget that you've ever felt nervous at all, Oggy.
Ah, I understand. And I don't feel nervous anymore either. My butterflies have gone! Just like Owen. You'll never need those armbands again.
Now I've shown you what to do, so the rest is up to you.
I'm sorry, you two. I've let you down.
But did the binoculars help?
Oh, yeah. It's all right to feel nervous or scared. I saw that even if you feel a bit shy to start off with, you soon feel better.
We understand. Let's hope the dragons won't mind if we don't sing at the concert.
But I can do it. I feel better now.
Brilliant!
Come on.
Can I change my mind?
No, you can't.
Now cut those claws. Let's hear applause.
Oh, I think we're too late.
Now for our newest act. The Bobbinogs!
Oh, no!
I can't land in time. But use my umbrella.
Where are they? Let's hear it for the Bobbinogs! What an entrance. These Bobbinogs are good.
Well, the dragons loved us. I'm so glad.
Now I really understand. You can still do things even when you feel a bit nervous or scared.
Oh!
Ah, look! The dragons are flying home!
Look! There's Cedric!
Goodbye. See you next year. Oh, look out!
Butterflies inside our tummy, legs are wobbly, feel all funny when we're feeling scared. Butterflies inside our tummy, legs are wobbly, feel all funny when we're feeling scared. But just try not to worry, it will be okay. Be brave and smile, and in a while the butterflies go away. Butterflies inside our tummy, legs are wobbly, feel all funny when we're feeling scared. Butterflies inside our tummy, legs are wobbly, feel all funny when we're feeling scared. We're not feeling nervous, human dragons roar. They're loving us, the Bobbinogs. They're calling out for more and more and more and more and more!
Hey, that was great! I don't feel nervous now, and neither does Owen.
I won't need these armbands anymore, and I'm really hungry.
Looks nice, Owen.
So have all those butterflies gone?
Butterflies? What butterflies?
Next on CBeebies, it's the bedtime hour.
everyone's getting ready for Christmas.
Merry Christmas!
I have to collect the Greendale Christmas tree.
So where is Ajay and the tree?
The line's blocked.
I'll go and look for him. I can't make it through this snow. I need Pumpkin to go and find them.
This is one delivery Postman Pat has to make. Will they get back in time for Christmas? A Postman Pat special for Christmas Eve at 10 or 4 on CBeebies.
CBeebies, share the magic.
Hello there, you're watching CBeebies, and it's the bedtime hour. I'm just making my very own Christmas cards. I've cut a shape out of this potato, and look, made it into a snowman. Just finishing it off with some finger painting snow. Looks good, doesn't it? Well, there'll be some more snow later on in Bill and Ben, but first, it's time to join the library and the story makers.
Come on into the library. It's a place where I love to be. Look in a book, here's a story for you. Who makes stories when the day is through? Who makes stories when the day is through? Story makers, story makers, working through the night till the rising sun. Story makers, story makers, stories are fabulous, stories are fun.
Rossetti Wordsworth,
Jenny and Jackson,
working through the night till the rising sun.
Story makers, stories are fabulous, stories are fun. Come and be a story maker. Oh, look at the time. Time to go home now. All right.
Story
Had a nice day.
Story makers.
It's midnight in the library. Hello.
Time for all story makers to come out. Are you ready?
The sun is down, the stars are bright. Story makers come out at night. Oh, Rossetti Wordsworth, magical story maker here to make stories with you. Hello.
Oh, Jelly, doesn't the library look funny?
Everything is topsy-turvy. My head is very close to the floor, and my feet are pointing at the ceiling.
Oh, hello, story maker. You look sort of upside down, as if you were standing on your head.
Yes. Hello, you two.
Hello, Rossetti Spaghetti. You look funny.
Well, you two look funny too. You're all topsy-turvy. Yes. What are you up to?
Well, we were trying to stand on our heads, Rossetti, but it was too tricky. Yes. So we made this cushion mountain instead.
Yes, it's a bit of a wobbly mountain, Jelly. I think it's going to topple.
No, stop wriggling, Jackson. Stop wriggling.
Uh-oh, looks like a bit of a tumble coming up.
Whoa, I'm a roly-poly jelly.
And I'm a leaping Jackson.
Are you two having fun?
Yes, Rossetti, yes. Because I roly-polied all the way to the bottom.
Let's do it again, Jelly.
Yes, I will, Jackson, but first I want to make a story.
Oh. Well, that's a good idea. Well, why don't we make a story out of some tumbles?
What sort of tumbles?
Oh, this sort. Like this. Rumbly-tumbly. Fingery-thumbly, roly-poly over.
Oh, Rossetti, that's funny.
Tumbly-bumbly, rumbly-mumbly. Will you say it again?
Well, why don't you two go and say it into the story machine? See what kind of story it makes.
Oh, yes, yes. Come on, Jelly.
Are you ready to rumble, Jackson?
Yes. Rumbly-tumbly, fingery-thumbly, roly-poly over.
Now we need some imagination. You'll help us, won't you?
Imagine, imagine, imagine a story.
it going to be?
I don't know.
Here it comes. Oh, it's a playbook.
And it's called My Rumble Tumble Day. Jelly Hour Tumbles Work.
Yeah. Hello, my name is Sophie and I'm with all my friends. We're at our playgroup where we have so much fun. Look at all the things we can do. So much to play with and a slide too. I want to climb the ladder first. Come on, follow me. Up and up the steps I go. One, two, three. I climb up high to the top. I look around. What a sight. The room looks different from up here. Hold on tight. I love the slide. It's so much fun. I get down to the floor. Whee! Look at me! I want to do that lots more. But my friend Amy likes to get down low and roll along the mat. I love the tube best of all. I climb into the hall, then crawl along in the dark. I feel just like a mole. I tunnel through on my hands and knees. First I crawl in, and then I come out. Where are you all? That was great, I shout. Look at Amy, like a monkey, swinging through the trees. You have to be strong and hold on tight, or you'll fall onto your knees. Amy walks along the beam and tries to balance and not fall off. It's not easy. Whoops, she slipped. It doesn't hurt, the floor's soft. I feel like I'm in a circus, just like a funny clown. I balance on a barrel as it turns round and round. I hold onto these two bars to help me on my way. Oh, I've made it to the other side. I've done it. Hooray! Oh no, it's the end of the day. But never mind, we'll come back next week. Hooray!
Oh, Sophie and her friends were having a very rumbly-tumbly time in that story, weren't they?
Yes.
Just like you two, roly-poly. Yes. Aren't you giddy yet?
Yes, Rosetti, I think I need a bit of a rest now.
No, oh, that's a good idea, Jellybean.
Mm. Hey, Rosetti, you look funny.
Funny?
Yes, sort of back to front.
Mm. Oh, yes, look! I've got my cardigan on the wrong way round. Oh, I better put it the right way round, otherwise I won't be able to reach my magic pocket. There, that's better.
Yes, the thing is, your shoes look funny too.
My shoe? What? I've got my socks on the outside when they should be on the inside. I'm all opposites.
Because inside and outside are opposites, aren't they?
Yes, that's right, Jelly.
And back to front is opposite as well.
Very good, Jackson. Yeah. Yes, well, can you think of any more opposites?
Happy and sad are opposites.
Yes, that's right. Happy and sad. Oh, that reminds me of a trick. Now, hang on a minute, where have I put that? Yes, here it is. Now, look very closely at this. Can you see on the outside, I've drawn a happy smiley face.
Yeah.
And on the inside is a sad, a grumpy face.
Oh, yes, that's a very sad mouth.
Now, watch very carefully, Jackson. See if you can see the face changing.
It's sad. It's happy. It's sad. It's happy. Oh, it keeps moving.
Wow. I love it.
Could we use it to make a happy and sad story?
Yes, all right then. Here, Jackson, I'll leave that to you.
Okay. I'll take it to the story machine. In it goes. I hope it makes a happy story and not a sad story. Will you help me with the next part? Because we need lots of imagination to make a story. Imagine a story. What's it going to be? Oh, it's a Kevin the Spaceman story. And it's called Planet Opposite.
Heaven and Spanner had seen this planet very clearly from space. One half of it was quite mountainous, and the other half was smooth and shiny. They were standing on the smooth, shiny side.
"Goodbye," said a voice.
Kevin looked round. It was a strange-looking boy with a sad face. "Hello," said Kevin. "I'm..."
"Goodbye,"
said the boy. Kevin and Spanner turned to go. Kevin was disappointed. "Bye," he said.
"Hello,"
said the boy, who now had a happy face. Kevin and Spanner were confused. Should they go or stay? Barked Spanner. Kevin thought he would try again. "Hello," he said in his most friendly voice. "I'm Kevin, and this is my dog Spanner." Barked Spanner, wagging his tail and trying to look encouraging. The boy span round.
"Goodbye," said the unhappy side. "I'm Ollie Opposite. Unhappy to meet you."
He spun round again, to the happy side.
"Hello, happy to meet you,"
he said. Kevin smiled. What a strange planet.
Where exactly are we?" asked Kevin politely.
Planet opposite,
said both sides of Ollie at once.
Jump over here.
Planet opposite, that explained it.
"Please stand up,"
said Ollie, sitting down.
"Stand up," said Kevin. "Oh, I see. The opposite of stand up is sit down. Thanks."
Ollie Opposite produced a delicious-looking jam sandwich.
"Would you hate something to eat?"
Kevin was beginning to get the hang of this.
No, thank you," said Kevin, taking one. "I hate jam sandwiches."
"Well, that's good," said Ollie, as Kevin tucked in. "Don't enjoy it."
Spanner whined.
"Oh, yes, and at the bottom of this mountain there's a bone for your dog."
Spanner rushed to the bottom of the mountain and began digging.
"Spanner," laughed Kevin. "This is planet opposite. When Ollie says at the bottom, he means at the top."
There at the top of the mountain was a juicy bone. Spanner tucked in. He liked planet opposite. When the friends had finished their meal, it was time to go.
"Hello,"
said Ollie.
"Don't come back."
Kevin hoped he would meet Ollie Opposite again.
"We won't," he laughed.
"Hello." And Spanner woofed hello too.
Ollie Opposite kept saying goodbye when really he meant hello. He said everything the wrong way round.
Yes, can we play an opposite game now, Jackson?
No, we can't.
Oh.
I'm being Ollie Opposite.
Oh.
I meant yes, we can.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Well, if you're being Ollie Opposite, you have to do the opposite of everything I say. So, I say stand still like a statue.
Oh, well, the opposite of standing still is to be very wriggly.
Yeah.
So, wriggle, 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 wriggle.
Wriggle, wriggle, wriggle. That's right, Jackson. Well, can I be Ollie Opposite now?
No, you can't, Jelly. Which means yes, you
can, yes.
Jelly.
Okay.
So, Ollie Opposite, please be very quiet.
Okay, well, the opposite of quiet is loud.
Yes.
So, la-di-da-da, la-di-da-da, la-la-la-la.
Oh, dear me, Jelly Bean, do you have to be quite so loud?
Oh, well, yes, because Jackson and I are playing an opposites game, and he said I had to be quiet, which means that I have to be loud. La-la-la-la, la-la-la-la.
That's very good, Ollie Opposite, but now please be very loud.
Okay, la 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 la, la la la.
Oh,
la.
That's better. Are you ready to make a story?
No, thank you, Rossetti.
Oh, okay.
Well, when Ollie Opposite says no, thank you, she means yes, please.
Oh, I see. Ooh, I'm beginning to feel very topsy turvy. Now, what should we put in the story machine? Well, perhaps I can find something with my magic spy hall.
Oh, yes.
Well. Isn't that a funny thing?
What?
Even my magic spy hall has gone all topsy-turvy.
Well, can I see, Rossetti?
Yeah, look.
Oh, there's a picture of an upside-down sky. Can we use that to make a story?
Yes. Well, you get ready by the story machine and I'll go and get the picture.
Okay.
Ah. In it goes. What a topsy-turvy world it would be if the grass was in the sky and the sky was where the grass should be.
Yes. Now we need lots of imagination.
Imagine a story.
I wonder which one it will stop at. Oh, it's a blue cow story.
Oh, and it's called Blue Cow Goes Topsy-Turvy.
One day, Blue Cow was looking up at the sky. I wonder what it's like to be up in the sky looking down at my field.
She's off again, said the other cows.
So Blue Cow caught the bus that stops beside her field. I'd like a ticket to a place where I can look down from the sky, please.
There you go, madam. Hold very tight.
And they set off for an airfield. And then they arrived. In front of her was a shiny red plane. Ooh. It had two sets of wings and a propeller at the front.
Spiffing, isn't she?
Said a man with a magnificent moustache.
I'm Captain Timothy Topham Turnpike, but my friends call me Timmy. Do you want to come for a ride on the plane?
Ooh, yes, please. I'm Blue Cow.
Super. You'll be needing these.
And he gave her a pair of goggles, a long white scarf, and a helmet.
Okie dokie, this way.
Ooh, and there's only one seat.
Of course, you're going to stand on the wings.
Ooh. Timmy and Blue Cow got onto the wing of the plane and he helped her to put on a big seat belt called a harness.
Ooh.
Timmy jumped into his seat.
Chalks away, off we go.
The plane sprang into life. Up, up, up into the air they went. Hooray!
Hold on tight, said Timmy,
as he turned the plane upside down.
Everything's topsy-turvy.
The fields, trees and houses were all above Blue Cow's head. Moo-tastic! I can see my field and all the other cows. Cooey!
Coming in to land,
shouted Timmy, turning the plane the right way up. Timmy helped Blue Cow out of the harness and down to the ground.
Splendid being upside down, isn't it?
Moo, yes, thank you. It makes you a little bit dizzy, though, she said as she wobbled back to the bus. You'll never guess where I've been.
Where have you been?
I've been topsy-turvy in a plane and I saw you all from the sky.
Everyone knows that cows can't be topsy-turvy.
But we know they can, don't we?
Didn't Blue Cow look fantastic standing on the wing of that aeroplane?
Yes, she was very brave.
Yes, because the plane turned upside down and everything looked topsy-turvy.
It's been a bit topsy-turvy in the library tonight.
Yes, it's been very funny.
But it's nearly morning. Look, the sun is unsleeping its beams. It's time for us to hide.
Yes, the children will be here soon. Come on, Jelly.
Bye.
Yes, my sweets. Dawn is upon us. The morning is nigh. We've made our stories and we bid you...
Hello!
I think they've still got a touch of the Ollie opposites. Goodbye.
Story makers, story makers. Working through the night till the rising sun. Story makers, story
goodbye
makers.
Goodbye for now.
Come back and see us soon.
Come and make some more stories soon.
Story maker.
flubba lubba dubba.
Here on CBeebies.
It's time we had some fun. Snowball fight.
Yes!
An Underground Denny special, Saturday at 11:20 or 5:20.
CBeebies, share the magic.
How would you like to play a game with me? You would? Brilliant. Look, I've wrapped this present. See if you can guess what it is. I'll give you a clue. It's got a spout and it has two handles, one for holding and one for pouring. Any ideas? Yes, that's right. It's a watering can, just like you'd find in the garden with Bill and Ben.
Bill and Ben. Bill and Ben, the flower pot man. The flower pot, Bill and Ben. The flower pot man. Bill and Ben, flower pot man. And they're playing in the garden with their friends.
One morning, the garden was covered in snow and ice, and Bill and Ben were still asleep when Whimsy the spider hurried past their flower pots.
Oh dear me! Oh dear!
Whimsy? Whatever's the matter?
Matter? Oh dear! I'm sorry, I can't stop!
Bill! Ben! Wake up!
Flubbadee?
Something's wrong with Whimsy! She's so upset she wouldn't stop to talk.
Oh, we didn't flub at all.
She went that way.
Bill thought Whimsy might have gone to next door's garden. So Bill asked Gnome to nod his head if Whimsy had stayed in their own garden. Gnome didn't nod his head.
Ooh.
That meant Whimsy must have gone into next door's garden.
Whimsy? Are you hiding?
Yes. Please don't tell anyone where I am.
Of course not.
Robin Whimsy knows.
Yes, Whimsy's hiding over there. Ooh, pardon me. I wasn't meant to say that.
I'm hiding because the man who works in the garden woke me up. He knocked the snow from where I was hiding, so I had to run away.
Flubba-dubba-dadded.
Oh, Bill, you are brave. Awful. I will show you where it happened, but only if you stay with me.
Oh, flubba-lubba-lay.
Look, the man moved all the snow around with his spade and I'm sure he was looking for spiders.
Flubba-flubba-death?
Was he making a path? Oh. Yes, perhaps he was.
Excuse me. Is anyone there? Oh, the flubber log. It's me, Boo. Hello. Thank you for finding me. Flubber-dubber-dye. I wasn't trying to hide. I was fast asleep, and then I woke up and found I'd been covered in snow. Oh, look, a shiny fat man. Did he cover me?
That's not a man, Boo. It's a pile of snow.
Oh, is it? Well, I'm off to find a sleeping place where no one can cover me with a pile of snow. Flubba-lubba-lo-man.
Yes, he does look a bit like a man, but he hasn't got any eyes or a mouth.
Oh, yeah, Whimsy, a flubba-lubba-gal-gal-lad.
Yes, all right. I'll guard the shiny man while you find some eyes. I can hide behind him if anyone comes. Oh, who's this?
Nuts. Nuts. I'm sure I buried some nuts.
Oh!
What's this?
Hello, Scump. He's a shiny man made out of snow.
Well, well. A shiny man of snow. Now, nuts, nuts. Where are my nuts?
Ben thought he found an eye for the shiny man.
Flubble eyes. Flubba-dubba-douth.
Bill thought it looked more like a mouth.
A
Bill's marbles look just like eyes.
Oh, flubbered eyes.
Oh, yes. Now he really is a shiny man of snow.
Flubber laugh and flubber that.
Oh, a hat and scarf. That's perfect.
My word. Your shiny man has dressed up.
Frubberlax.
We'd can't wait to see him.
Huh?
I said you'd take him to meet her.
Oh, but Flubber, go!
Hello. Oh, who's this?
A Flubber-lubber-da-da-do.
A man of snow?
Bill and Ben have to take him to meet Weed, but, oh, I don't know how they'll get him there.
I've got an idea. I've seen children pull each other around on sliding things made of metal and wood. They're called sledges.
Ah, a sledge, eh? A sliding thing? A thing that slides over the snow? Got it! Fetch me a length of good stout string. Why are you standing still? Hurry up! Slublob! In my shell, of course! Now pass one end of the string into my leg hole. I'll just move it through my shell. There. Good. Now pull it until two parts of the string are the same length. Now tuck me over the snow. There, you see, the perfect sledge.
Hurrah for Snubbleum!
Ho, ho, ho! Ah, yes, I love sliding. Oh, I've never had so much fun.
Oh, hee hee. Oh, Flubbernop.
Why have you stopped?
Rubber-dubber-dift.
Well, yes, I suppose you do need something to lift your shiny man. But be quick.
Oh, I do hope no one comes and makes me jump. Someone's coming.
Don't waste any time. Get that snowman onto my back. I can't wait to go sliding again.
Timsy, Flubber-dided?
No, Ben, I wasn't hiding. I was guarding the shiny man. From behind.
Oh.
Oh, your sledge looks just like Snow Coach.
It is me, you silly spider.
Oh.
Come on, let's take your shiny man to eat Weed.
Oh.
A shiny man of snow. My word, he is handsome. And how clever of you to bring him on a sledge.
Morning, Weed.
A talking sledge.
Dobber Slobberlob.
Slow Coach? So it is.
Right, that's enough chatter. Leave the shiny man to talk to Weed. Let's go sliding.
A Flubber-dider back?
Yes, you can ride on my back, if you hurry.
Bill and Ben soon found out what fun it was to ride on their new sledge.
Someone else. Oh, I'll hide behind the shiny man. Oh, he's gone.
Oh, Flubber-dimsy. Flubber-died?
Oh, me? Have a ride on Slow Coach.
Don't mess about. Climb aboard.
Well, it does look fun.
Oh, hey,
this really is fun. Oh, yes. Oh, this is great!
What on earth? Slow Coach!
Oh, thank you for the ride.
Oh, Flubber Slubber Lob. Of course I'm all right. I feel 100 years younger.
Well, you might be all right, Slow Coat, but you've ruined my new sleeping place.
Sorry about that, Boo.
Well, that's the trouble you cause when you race about. You should stay in one place like me.
Yes, well, perhaps we have had enough excitement for one day. But what excitement!
Later on, Bill and Ben introduced the shiny man to Gotten Gnome.
Flubber-dubber-dome.
but they didn't seem interested in talking to each other. Bill and Ben didn't mind. They were too tired after all the excitement. But as Slowcoach had said, what excitement!
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long.
It's time to find with the Fimbles, next on CBeebies.
Waiting for Christmas is so exciting.
One day I opened the door.
I had a horse with twigs on his head.
Huh? One day you opened
the
door.
Now where's the last door?
Where has Christmas gone?
It's a catastrophe.
It is a catastrophe.
Follow Charlie and Lola in their magical search for Christmas.
It's Christmas land.
Cattle are moving.
A Charlie and Lola Christmas special at 10:30 or 4:30 on Christmas Eve.
CBeebies, share the magic.
Hello, I'm David. I know a story of a boy whose gran lived a long, long way away. Keep watching, and I'll read it to you very soon.
Every girl, every boy, come on, open up your eyes. There's a world right here.